All right, it is the end of September, and by my calendar, that means it's time for full-out Halloween mode. And this year, like last year, I'm trying to do the movie a day for the whole month. Now, last year I wasn't completely successful with it, just for the fact that stuff comes up, sometimes I don't have time to watch the movie I'd wanted to, or other times I catch something on TV that I'd rather watch instead, but it's a nice guideline to have, and it's fun to try to do it, so I'm doing it again this year. And this year I decided to kind of change it up a bit. I've made the days into different categories, and also I tried to include a lot more movies I've never seen before. So maybe to add a little extra incentive to doing this. We're going to have campy Sundays, just basically campy or horror comedy movies. Halloween Mondays, since Halloween is on a Monday this year, it's going to be Halloween-themed movies, I guess you could say. Silent Tuesdays. Haven't seen very many silent horror films, but I like the ones I've seen, so give myself the reason to check out more of them. Remake Wednesday. Zombie Thursday. Slasher Friday, even though we don't have a 13th this month. Old School Saturdays. And we're starting off the month on a Saturday, so we have Bela Lugosi in White Zombie, which I've owned for quite a while and never actually gotten around to watching. So I'm excited to finally watch that one. Sunday, we got Killer Clowns from Outer Space. I wanted to watch this one early on in the month because I may actually be able to meet the cast from that movie. Night of the Demons on Monday. Once again, something I've never seen, but according to the summary online, it takes place on Halloween. So I figured it was a good one to throw in here. Phantom of the Opera for the first silent film. First remake here, we got My Bloody Valentine 3D. I'm not sure if I'm going to watch the 3D version or not, but it could be interesting. Return of the Living Dead. I know technically that this would be a horror comedy to some extent, but I want to throw it in with the zombies. Psycho for the first slasher. Now at this point we'll probably be down in Orlando, so I want to pick stuff that I had on DVD. And that Saturday there, we'll be going to the Spooky Empire Horror Convention, just like we did last year. As I mentioned before, the cast from Killer Clowns is going to be there. A lot of people, Kane Hodder, Derek Mears, Tony Todd, Clive Barker. The list goes on. I think most of the leather faces are going to be there. Gonna try to get some more autographs, and I'll do that whole documentary on that trip, just like I did last year, too. I had a lot of fun with it last year. But the movie for that Saturday is The Wolfman, so maybe we can squeeze it in after the whole convention thing. Maybe not. I've seen it a billion times, though. It's one of my favorite Universal horror movies, so I figured if I had to skip it, it wouldn't be the worst thing. That Sunday, Skinned Deep. I had this on the list last year, and we actually didn't get around to watching it. It's such a crappy, awful horror movie. I love it. I loved it the first time I saw it. It was just a ridiculous mess. There's a little person throwing plates, actually, Warwick Davies, so a very famous little person actor, is a killer who throws plates. There's a guy with a giant brain. There's this guy, the Surgeon General. It's just a mess of a movie, and it's hilariously awful. I highly recommend getting drunk and watching this. And for as little known as this movie is, I mean, the picture you're seeing here is actually a scan I had to make of the DVD cover because I couldn't find a high-res picture online of the cover of the DVD. Sleepy Hollow, I know it doesn't actually take place on Halloween from what I could read, but from what I saw, it's kind of like implied that it's near Halloween. I don't know, I've never seen it. I just need another Halloween movie, and this is one I could find. The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari, another silent film I've never gotten around to seeing. Actually, I don't think I've seen any of the silent films I have on my list right now. This one was recommended to me by my high school English teacher in senior year. And I've never gotten around to watching it, but I'm excited to see it. Remake. I decided not to go with all modern remakes, so I tried to put ones that I'd heard are actually good. So The Fly, I've never seen this one again. Kind of embarrassed all the movies I haven't seen on this list. It sounds like I don't watch any horror movies. 28 Days Later for the zombie flick that week. Freddy vs. Jason for the slasher film. I decided to kind of just do this one, put the two together, because I didn't have room for both Nightmare on Elm Street and Friday the 13th films in here. Plus, I believe this is also going to be the closest we'd have to a Friday the 13th. So, it's an appropriate time. Frankenstein for the classic movie. One of my all-time favorite horror movies. Attack of the Killer Tomatoes for Sunday there. Once again, something I've never seen, but kind of wanted to for quite a while. Trick or Treat, my absolute favorite Halloween movie. Oh, I'm not sure if I should say that. Halloween is a very close second to it. I don't know, they kind of switch back and forth in my head. But I love Trick or Treat. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, or Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, if you go by the author's pronunciation. This is supposed to be kind of a wild movie. It's not as tame as you'd think most old movies are, from what I've heard, so very excited to check it out. Dawn of the Dead for the remake, not for zombies. One of my favorite remakes out there, I gotta say. Zombie, the technically Italian sequel to Dawn of the Dead, but not really, but kind of. Hatchet. Gotta throw that in for a slasher movie. Once again, one of my new favorites. Freaks for the old school movie. Very interested to see this one. I've never seen it, and it seems like quite the concept. Definitely a movie you could not make today. So, very interested to see it. Shaun of the Dead. Once again, a movie I absolutely love. Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. I think at this point, we're 7 more days till Halloween. Yeah, I'm not going to sing this time. I have to watch it every year. It's just mandatory viewing. I know a lot of people hate this movie. I actually really like it as like a total guilty pleasure. And it's just ridiculous. Just don't think it was a Michael Myers movie, and because it isn't at all. But it's a lot of fun for me. Faust. Another silent film directed by F.W. Murnau, who did Nosferatu. I know this one's supposed to be kind of like heaven and hell and all stuff. I don't think I've seen any of these silent movies, so I'm excited to see it. The Blob for remake. I just watched the original for the first time and I really enjoyed it, and I've heard mixed reviews on the remake, but once again, trying to get a remake in there that's not from this decade, so trying to back up a little bit. Zombieland. Love Zombieland. High Tension. I was trying to find other slasher films to put in the list, things I haven't seen, and that's kind of a hard thing to do, to find a slasher film that is not complete crap to put on the list. But I heard decent things about this one, so I figured I'd give it a shot. The Invisible Man for the classic movie. If you've never seen this one, it has a really funny, I guess, sense of humor. I don't know how to really describe it. It's definitely an interesting movie. It's not what all I expected to watch when I sat down for this the first time. I would really recommend this if you normally wouldn't give this kind of thing a chance. I don't know, it's a unique movie. It's not as melodramatic as some of the other old Universal horror movies. Evil Dead 2. Once again, I mean, campy movie, horror comedy, whatever you want to call it, always a good time. And then, I mean, you gotta end it out on Halloween. No matter how much I like Trick or Treat, you gotta go with the original Halloween movie here. and just have to do it. Can't avoid it at all. So that's my list of movies for the month of October. As I said, I'll be doing some other videos in there. I'll be doing the rundown of the whole convention thing. And I know I got a request recently to do a video on my DVD collection, so I'll probably be doing that sometime soon. But if you guys have movies you're watching for the month of October, if you just have something you watch every year, or you're going to do something like this, you know, let me know, comment below, do a video response, something. It'd be kind of cool to see what other people are planning to do for their Halloween rituals and all that stuff. So, I'll see you guys later.